Hey, I'm back in the shop today. Going to work on a couple little projects. We made a lot of progress over the weekend. I've been doing a lot of thinking on how I'm going to approach this install and some other things I can do. As you can see, I've got the new hot water heater in the opening where it fits. The wood was a little wider, and they do accommodate that with the new door system that comes with this unit. This is approximately a little bit over 1¾ inches on both sides. And rather than buy a piece of, or build out of wood, or buy a piece of metal that I had to cut, I actually ordered a piece of 1¾ by 1¾ aluminum angle with a 1/8-inch web, and which will fit this opening perfectly. And I can screw one side of the angle into the aluminum frame of the trailer and have a nice flat surface here to mount the new hot water heater to. I can also seal around that very well with a sealant, and it'll be a nice tight opening for the new hot water heater to go into. Okay, so still in the shop today. I've isolated the wires that were coming to the original hot water heater. I've determined that these, the white and the green wire, are the power wires for to engage the electric side of the hot water heater up in the control panel of the trailer. And I've isolated the blue and the orange wire as the circuit which enabled the gas side of the hot water heater. And I've already installed the little butt splice, or the butt connectors. And as you can see, I've got 12 volts on that circuit. The other one's turned off right now, but making a little progress here. All right, so a lot of little projects end up being one big project. These little control wires coming off of the back of the hot water heater, there's no polarity to them, so you can really, when they connect to the control unit for the hot water heater, it doesn't matter which wire connects to which. Also, it doesn't matter if the wires are blue. I'm about to tin the wires because I'm going to solder them into these little butt connectors, because the wire itself is too small for the crimp to hold. So go ahead and tin this wire. Very easy to do. The other one, I'll do that one too. A little solder, and that's all it takes. Now the butts, the splices themselves have to be filled with solder, and then I will heat them up and stick the wire in and let it cool off. Pretty easy to do. Got to put a little bit of flux in there so that the solder will flow properly. Put a little bit in there. Don't need much. It'll work. And probably going to get this soft right here, but it doesn't matter. It's going to be covered up anyway. Oops, I need solder. There. Tighten up a little vise. And here we go. There we go. A little bit more. There we go. All right. And now let's heat it up and shove the wire in. All right, I'll feel it and let it solidify, and boom. There we go. Wire is soldered in the connector. Now I just got to do the other one. All right, next step here is we're installing, or preparing to install, this hot water heater control unit. Two blue wires, There's no polarity on these wires. You can connect however you want back to the hot water heater. They don't give you the wire, so I am using a jacketed PVC wire at 16.2. It's rated for low voltage power wire, or you can use it for speaker wire, whatever you want, but that's what I'm using. I had some guy read where some gentleman was saying, hey, you gotta get some blue wire to do that. No, you don't have to blue wire. It doesn't matter what color the wire is. This is 16.2. And it just happens to have a jacket on it, which kind of protects it for going through the walls of an RV, and I like that, and that's why I'm using it. So, anyway, this is pretty straightforward here. There is a process to putting these two wires together, though. This is a process I learned many years ago working for an electrical engineering company. It involves tinning the wires first, tinning them. I've already shown you that. Pretty straightforward. And then I've already done all the others, but you basically just take a small pair of needle nose, you grab the very end of that tinned wire, and you do a little loop in it like so, like that right there. Little loop. And I've already got my heat shrink to cover up those wires, slid that back over the blue wires here. Got another piece of heat shrink on the white wire down here, push it down so I don't get it hot. And what you basically gonna do is hook the little hooks together and solder them. And that's about it. So when I get done, I'll show you what the finished product is. All right, I've got these wires all soldered up. Putting the heat shrink, sliding up over the solder connections. Good to go. And now the final thing to do to finish up this termination here is to slide this white heat shrink back down over those wires. Get that to go in there. There we go. All the way down inside. That way it's protected. In fact, you know what? Changed my mind. Let's pull it out so I don't have to put heat down in there. And I will heat. Now, there you go. You've got your control unit, and the wire is permanently connected to it to go down through the wall. Hey, back inside the RV today, we made some progress, actually. I've got the control unit mounted for the unmanned hot water heater. It's actually pretty easy. This is like a single layer Luon material, so I had to go inside this cabinet and just use some little small fender washers and mounted it from the back side with some fender washers. They were saying use number 8 screws that were 1 inch long with that Luon is just not strong enough in my opinion. So I'm using just some machine screws and fender washers. And as you can see, I sort of tidied up my wire going down the wall. And then also down here. And one more time down there. And I went down into that lower cabinet where the utilities are, and then I've terminated my wire right down here, which will plug right into the back of the control unit wires for the hot water heater itself. So making a little progress.
Okay, now I'm back outside right now, still on Sunday. Want to introduce my little stepdaughter, Madeline. Madeline, say hi.
Hi.
All right, so, and today what we've actually accomplished some more things down here. And in preparation for putting this hot water heater in, I've actually got this gas line installed and got it all tightened up, pressurized it with gas, and I used some Camco stop leak to check for leaks in. We're looking good there. That's about all for today. I am still waiting on a lot of components from Amazon, some fittings and some other things. So I'm kind of in a holding pattern now until we can get some more items in. All right, that's good. Have a good evening. Okay, Madeline is gonna demonstrate her skating prowess today for us. So go ahead, Madeline. Here we go. All right.